Hey, what is up guys? My name is Kasmin and today I'll be going through the whole process of designing a logo inside Illustrator. Now I will be using Photoshop, but just briefly to sketch some ideas out. You can use a pen and a paper for that, that's no problem. So let's go ahead and get started. Now here's the project brief. As you can see, the name of the company is West Coast Renewables and they build electrical car chargers for commercial businesses. Now these chargers are installed inside parking lots and they say to look at EV chargers to get some inspiration, and that's exactly what I'll do. Right off the bat, I'm going to look for some inspiration on sites like Logobond or even Google to see what some of the competitors are doing, and that will help me understand the industry better. Now you can spend as much time as you'd like in this stage, and the more information you gather, the more prepared you're going to be once you start sketching up ideas. Now you have to understand that this is a very important stage of the process. This will help you set a foundation and even possibly imagine a couple of ideas in your head once you search through all of these. Now there's no way I can call what's going through my head when I'm gathering all of this information and all of this inspiration, but most of the time I start picturing different ideas and even adjust some of the ones I see on screen to fit with the task at hand. So as you can see, I'm taking an example from the bolt from the blue logo and I start with that. Now in my opinion, in this project the hardest part is coming up with the graphical symbol that makes sense for the company, but that's what makes it so exciting. That's the best part. With logo design there are so many ideas that can work for a company. You can give this test to 10 designers with the same brief and you'll probably get very different results. Now what makes each designer different in my opinion is their process. Now I used to just jump into Illustrator and start doing the first idea that came into mind and commit to it. So even if it was a bad idea, I would have invested so much time in it and eventually ended up with a logo I wasn't too proud way too often. But that was before I started doing this whole process with sketching, as you can see, trying out variations of certain ideas. Now with the process I feel way more confident knowing that I've explored multiple ideas and even tweaked a couple of them to properly understand the potential of each one. The bottom line is I'm no longer worried about the result, knowing that if I follow every step I'm bound to develop a logo I can be proud of. That logo looks like Wonder Woman, but Wonder Woman doing a crossover episode with The Flash. So if Marvel ever wants to do that, just hit me up. This logo will be available for sale later on. I'm just kidding. Back to the logo, I really like this third idea with the bolt that comes up with the W wings. It looks pretty cool, even though it has a weird balance to it. I'm going to save it. And these two ideas are probably what I'll decide between. Now what you see now is I'm just exploring a couple of ideas to see how it will look. This doesn't mean these are the final type fonts I'm going to use. I'm just looking for how balanced the logo will eventually be, and now I can finally add it inside the Illustrator and start doing the vectors. As you can see, I just added an image, lowered its opacity and started tracing on top of it using the pen tool and just using various shapes. Now I'm just trying to figure out how I can make it look symmetrical, even though it has that bolt which has a weird just a weird orientation. Now getting back to what I was previously discussing about developing logos you can be proud of, just keep in mind that with worst case scenario the client doesn't like it, and I've come to be okay with that. It's no longer an issue. At the start I took everything very personal, but now I actually try and see what happens. I like to go back and try to understand what went wrong, whether if it's something I've missed or just something on the client's end, it's very important to address it and make sure you're not going to make the same mistakes again in future projects. This is where setting real expectations come in handy, and it will help you avoid some of these weird situations. Now, I've never had a project fail if I've kept it real with the client and told and showed him example of logos similar to what he received beforehand. So if you find yourself at the end of the process with a logo but you're scared to send it over to the client, that's not a good place to be. That means that you probably know that he'll want something different, or even worse, you don't know what he wants to see, and that's your responsibility. You have to make sure that you and your client share the same vision, and this is a logo he can use. Back to the logo at hand, I've already explored color options, and this is the final design. I'm also trying to see how it will look in just one color, or whenever it's placed inside a shape, as it is in this circle, so they can use that on the actual devices. So thank you for listening and watching. Hopefully you got a couple of tips. That was my goal, just to share my process and let you know how I ended up with this particular one. Now let me know if you have any questions in the comments, and I'd be more than happy to help. Okay, thanks, see you guys.